process videos as always, but just a little change. And I'm not sure how many I will do, but I like this idea. It's been rolling around in my head for a little bit and just wanted to give it a try. So the idea is that these are layouts where I make one big decision, one choice, to show you what thought is going through my head when I make that. So today I'm going to be scrapbooking this one 4x6 photo, and I've made some basic decisions already. I want to include a cloud print that's going to coordinate with his coat, and I wanted to bring in the red from his shoes. So I've started with those two papers. They're both from Starshine. But here's where I'm getting to the choice. I also want to include raindrops. And in fact, I used to have a raindrop paper that matched the colors on here so well that that's why I bought the coat, but that's another long story. But that was from True Stories, and I've used all that paper and I don't have any left. I have different raindrop prints. So I have this raindrop print from Little by Little, which is very colorful and full of pattern. It has two different shades of blue. It has both the royal blue and the navy. So I think that would work well with the colors that are on offer here. However, it doesn't have any red. And every time I look at this photo, I'm drawn to the red. It's in the buttons on his jumper, and then it's also in his shoes, on his jacket, sorry, jumper. Jumper has a very different meaning in America. In England, it's not a dress, just so you know. It's more like a sweater. Or a big sweatshirt. Anyway, I digress. Then I also have this raindrop print. This is from Amy Tangerine on a Whim. So these are both current papers right now. They both came out this January, and they're both multicolored raindrops. However, this one, it has the blue. It doesn't have two shades of blue. It has blue with black this time. But instead of staying so much with the pastel, it has more primary colors here, including the red. Now, both of them have pink. So if there's an issue of should I include pink on a page for a boy, it's not a problem in my albums, but it might be a problem in other people's albums. I'm not bothered by it. But what I really do like here is that I can bring in the red. And so then my next choice. So I'm already leaning toward this one because it has the red. But I still want to see what they both look like with the other papers that I've chosen. So I want to include, I know, the blue cloud and the red as an accent. So if I put these raindrops next to this, these two work really well together. I really like that combination. But the red looks out of place. So if I put this photo up here, this is not pulling in everything that I notice in the photo. So if I try the second paper, this works better with the red. And then I can see, because I have the red in the raindrop print, these three all work together. So that's as simple as I make that decision. This one is staying and this one is going. So I'll put that one back and use that some other time. And then that also makes my last decision for me, basically, because I knew I wanted something else that was a more subtle pattern than these. I could use plain white cardstock, but that's not my thing. So I wanted a pattern that I could put in the background without it overwhelming everything. And if I'd used the other one, I probably would have gone with something that had navy. But because this has black and white accents, I've gone with another paper from On a Whim. This is the B-side to Full Bloom, which is a black and white diagonal. It's not as harsh a diagonal as normal. It's kind of a little bit softer. Anyway, that same diagonal appears here on the raindrops. So everything then is tied together. So I've got two from Starshine, two from On a Whim, one 4x6 photo, and here I go. Really simple construction to start. The black and white pattern is going to be my background, and I'm just going to offset two pieces of pattern paper so that one goes off the top edge and one goes off the bottom edge. So I'm just checking that there's enough of that pattern visible that you can tell that it's clouds. And I'm wanting this paper over enough that when I put a photo on it, I'm not going to completely cover up the red raindrop. And I would prefer that this gap be pretty similar, not exact, but pretty similar to that one. And then I have my photo to run around here. But in fact, I do want it about there, and that is covering up the red. So I'm going to move this over a little bit further, which is fine. Like that. And then I want a little bit of red right behind here. So I think the best way for me to do that is to put this over the join, but to cut it shorter. And this is actually the branding strip from the black and white striped paper in the background. Wasn't the straightest cut I've ever made, so I'll tidy that up. By the way, I've had a few questions about adhesive because my long-term love of the this to that dots and has to come to an end soon because they aren't making it anymore. Oh, I say that right as I need to refill. Well, what I have is I have a small stash of refills left, and once I've worked through them, they are no more. So I'm investigating alternatives. The alternatives come from a whole bunch of different places. So there is an American Crafts alternative. So this is an American Crafts adhesive, and they just recently, well, not super recently, kind of reworked their adhesive offerings with a line called Sticky Thumb, which does include a roller, but they've consolidated what they're offering. So the Sticky Thumb roller is a solid, where with this to that you had options of solid tabs and dots. Solid isn't my favorite, but that doesn't mean that I couldn't use it. So anyway, that's one of the adhesives that I'm testing out. I've also got some other brands, and the thing that I want to see is not just how they are to use, which is a big part of it, but also, of course, how they hold up. So I'm hesitant to give a big hearty recommendation to anything right now because I haven't been trying other things long enough to see how they're holding up in albums. But I just wanted to let you know that I am doing that, and once I can start to see how things are going, then I will have a little report of what I liked and disliked. I want to bring a little bit of attention to the red raindrop. I mean, I don't want you to glare at it or anything, but I don't want it to feel lost. I want it to be noticeable. So I'm going to bring in other elements and place them close to that spot. So I'm going to have a journaling bit there, and I'm going to go ahead and put the title on just about there so that it overlaps as well, just so that the red is definitely part of the design. It's not going to get covered up or disappear, it's going to be right there. And the other part of my title I'm going to do in gray, which I don't actually have in the patterns that are there already, but there's certainly gray in the photo itself. And I have the black and white, so I think the gray will be just fine to be a bit more subtle rather than have another big color for these letters. And I was going to do more with this, but I actually think I'm going to bring in some smaller letter stickers yet to do the bit in the middle. Let's see. Those are on cream, so I will choose something different. Who still has these in their stash? Making memories. Going back. They are really useful stickers. They're such a lovely size, and there are a lot of them that were and white background or cream background. But these are in black. And I want it to read, "You are a joy." And I'm worried that if I put an A here, then it just looks like area instead of R-A. If I put it over here, it's going to get a bit wobbly. Just think, I mean, I'll show you what I mean. Can do that. But that sort of makes it look like a joy is a word, kind of like a jar. Could also try bringing the bigger A, the bigger gray A. Does that look less like a jar? What was it I said at the beginning? My whole goal here was to show you a layout where I only had to make one decision. I may have underestimated how difficult that would be. So I have two options there, two choices if I'm happy to leave this here, which I think I am. I can use a different letter, a different type of sticker for the A, or I could change it up entirely and not have it say, you are a joy. I could change the word, I could have it say, you are my joy, or something like that. What I really wish I had was a nice little scripty A that could go across there. So I don't even know if such a thing exists in my stash or if I could hand cut something. I'm sure I could do it with a silhouette, but I will tell you the truth. The silhouette takes so much time for me that by the time I get it all set up and make the word that I want to cut and actually get it cut and get back to the layout, the moment is gone for me. I really, really wish I could just mentally do it. But I can't. Okay, so I gotta see what I've got. I've pulled out three different script options. I've got this A in white. I've got this A, nice shape, and it's blue, but actually now that I look at it, that's not a good match to this blue, and that's gonna look all messy. So not that one. These, which are words, obviously, in case you hadn't noticed, it's not an alphabet. But what I was looking at was, could I just cut the A away from always and have a nice little curly glittery tail? But it does mean that I'm then going to waste this rest of this sticker unless I come up with a way that I could use ways in a title. So I'm going to try this one first. Although I do like the black glittery a lot. I can bring this so that it's in the middle here. And then build the joy around that. That'll work. Now it doesn't look like area. Unless you look at it for 10 minutes, and then of course everything stops looking like real words, doesn't it? Okay, my journaling's going to go on here, and I've got, although I didn't have my true stories and raindrop paper anymore, I have the stickers. So I'm going to do just a little bit over to this side, and some of these are cream, because the clouds in that collection were not white, they were cream. Again, I don't want to lose my red raindrop, so I'm going to put this cloud right along there, and I'm just choosing the ones that don't have the cream. I'm using the gray, silver, blue instead. And some foam squares so that I can have a little bit of dimension in my little storm here. One there, and then I want something to go on the diagonal from that, and that's going to be a little smaller grouping with one blue and one silver. And then again, some dimension to pick up that one. almost everything important is there now, of the journaling is there, but I want to put the date and location, and I want it to match this journaling box. So that was in the die cut pack, but I don't have another journaling piece in that green, but not in the die cut pack, but I do have this bit from the cut apart sheet, which is called Seriously, and I'm just cutting it down to two lines. So I've got one spot for the date and one spot for the location, and I'm going to bring that up to this corner up here. And I just need to trim it down a little bit so that I can tuck it behind here. So that's pretty much everything that needs to be there, plus a little bit of pattern and color for fun. So I could just leave it like that, and I could be finished. But to me, this is a little bit more bare than what I would like, so I'm going to add more stuff. But what I want to do is just keep that focus, that everything that's there is the most important stuff, and everything I add from here on out is kind of just a bit of optional fun. So I don't want it to overwhelm the stuff that's already there. So I'm starting with a little bit of gray mist, which goes on quite dark but then fades a bit. So you can start to see that dry into the background. I went to see what else I had from On a Whim that would have green, and there's the green in the stickers. There's a big piece on the front. It's really too big for what I have here, but there's a little one on the back that just says, yay! So I think that's a good one for the look on his face. And I think maybe I make a little grouping here that's going to include the green. I could also bring it up here, but I think that's then going to be a whole nother grouping up here is too much. Oh, or I could bring it here, which I didn't think of originally, but I actually kind of like. I think if I bring it here, then I've kind of brought the green over. Okay, I'm liking this better than this because I have that nice straight vertical in the exclamation. I could also have it overlapping here, but it was going to go right over the top of the writing, and I think what I'd like to do is have it have the gap, but then use that gap. So this may make some of you laugh because I started using this particular sheet of enamel dots in a class and just kept using it until it was almost gone. Well, I went back to that shop and they had them again, or still. I bought another set. So now I'm starting again with these beautiful enamel dots. Okay, I wanted to bring in that orange that's on the paper. So I'm going to add that on this diagonal. And what I was choosing there is, do I want it, I like to have a little bit of consistency in either putting them all so that they're on the edge of the paper going onto another paper, like they're on a cross of layers, or have them out in the open. So this is the out in the open option. So we're going to do that with the orange, and then I liked how this blue was matching as well. So then I'll take the other option for the blue, and I'll just use that on places where the papers overlap. I think that one makes the title a little bit hard to read, so instead I'll bring it over here. Oh, don't like that either. Because everything else is tucked under the photo there. But I would like three of them. Of course. So bring it down here to where I've got the red raindrop. So I'm bringing it to the red and the green. And a little triangle. And I'll bring some of that blue up to here because I don't have the red or the blue over here. There. One up here. Yeah, I wasn't sure about that because that does mean I have two in a straight line. But I don't like this one over the photo. Actually, I think if I just move that one up a little bit. Okay, I think I like that best. Either would work. Okay, that's probably enough from that sheet of enamel dots, so I'll leave that. Anything else? I think next thing I'll go to is stamps to add a little bit. Yeah, a little bit of stamping in, probably in the gray. Just going to use a really small block with some little light text stamps. I was looking for things that wouldn't be big, heavy words, so just little letters to then go into these little groupings, and do that with gray ink so that it's not super heavy. And I'm totally gonna mess that up. There we go. Today again, I went right over the top of the enamel dot, and the enamel dot is too tall. Oh, that time I got away with it. Do one more. Right down here at the bottom. I'm going to take the enamel dot off this time so it doesn't stress me out. And then put it back on. Okay, really, really simple. But I don't think that I would want to add anything else at that point. I'm looking because it is a little bit less than what I put on some of my pages, but I think that's actually quite enough. And I didn't end up using the big red pattern that I pulled out at the beginning, because I think this one was enough, especially because I wanted the red to pick up on his shoes, and that goes in a line that makes your eye fill in the gap with the red in his shoes. So that works. Yep, that's where I'm going to finish it. Thanks so much for watching, and I will come back again where I'm choosing between two papers or two colors or something like that, and another simple page in this series. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.